You have seen that you need to be very careful with the log, both with the log with small l and the log with capital L. The rules you are familiar with from real analysis do not always hold. If you want to know whether certain rules still hold, you have only one option. Start out with the definition and check it. We'll do so for two important examples in this video, the derivative of log z and a rule for the log of z1 times z2. So let us start with the derivative of log z. So if we said w equals log z, what's then dw dz? Well, we can find that using implicit differentiation, because if we know if w equals the log of z, then we know that e to the power w equals e to the power log of z. And we have seen in the previous example that e to the power log of z is always equal to z if z is not equal to zero. We can use this to compute the derivative dw dz. So what can we do? We take the d dz of e to the power w, that equals the d dz of z equals 1. And we can work out the d dz of e to the power w using implicit differentiation, use the chain rule. That is the d dw of e to the power w times dw dz. So it yields the e to the power w times dw dz. So we're over here, equals 1. And we know that e to the power w equals z. So we find z dw dz equals 1. So dw dz equals 1 over z. So we have our familiar rule, the derivative of the log of z is just 1 over z, exactly the same as with real analysis. So that's nice. What about our second example? Well, we have already seen that capital log of z is not necessarily equal to 2 times capital log of z. Depends on the value of z. So we know that if you have log capital log of z1 times z2, won't be equal to capital log of z1 plus capital log of z2, because the log of z squared is a special case of that, with z1 equals z2. So for capital log of z, this identity probably will not hold. It will not hold for all values of z. What about a small log of z? So what about this statement? Does that still hold if you replace the capital by a small log? So small log of z1, z2, can I rewrite it as small log of z1 plus small log of z2? Well, I have to use the definition for that. So what does this mean, the small log of z1 times z2? Well, the real part is the ln of the modulus of z1 times z2, so that's this term over here, plus the I times imaginary part, and the imaginary part of the small log is the small r of, in this case, z1, z2. It's over here. And then we can split it up. There are no problems with the ln of z1 times z2. That's all real, so you can split it up later on. Over here in an ln of z1 and an ln of z2. Modulus everywhere, so that part is fine. The hard part is in the step over here. Can we say that the argument of z1 times z2 equals the argument of z1 plus the argument of z2? Or how should you read it? Because the small argument of z1 is multivalued. The small argument of z2 is also multivalued. Well, the statement here is true. This equality is true if you read that as follows. A small arc of one complex number is equal to the small arc of the other complex number if there is a multiple of 2 pi I such that they are equal. If you can choose a particular branch such that they are equal. Oh, and that is of course the case of the argument of z1 times z2, because the argument of z1 times z2 equals the argument of z1 plus the argument of z2 plus a number of times 2 pi I. And the same holds for this expression over here. Maybe some other multiples of 2 pi I, but you can choose those multiples such that they are equal to the multiple in this line over here. Okay, and then we are done. Then we have done the hard work. Then you can rearrange the terms. Over here you have the log of z1, and over here you have the log of z2. So indeed, if you use a small log of z1 times z2, then it's equal to the log of z1 plus the log of z2. Where you really have to be careful with the interpretation in the case of the multivalued arguments. Still, in this case, the rule holds.